Hi everyone, if you're using IONOS hosting, this is the right video for you to set up a complete WordPress site. So in the process, we're going to follow a few steps. And the step number one is we're going to download the WordPress core files. Then we're going to upload them to the root directory. We're also going to create a database, connect a domain or subdomain to directory, install WordPress and perform a basic setup of WordPress site. So without further ado, let's get started. Step one, let's download the WordPress core files. So we go to wordpress.org, then get WordPress and download WordPress files. So select where you want to save it. Remember, make sure you remember it. So step two, let's upload the WordPress core files to the directory. So we're going to ionos.com and put in your details. Please, if it's your first time to watch videos in this channel, please subscribe. And in case you've been here before, welcome back. So in this case, you're going to hosting, but in case you don't see hosting, go to menu, then you click on hosting. So here you're going to use WebSpace and click use WebSpace. Then you're going to click on builds, upload, then you click select the file where you downloaded it. So it's here and you open it. So you're going to click upload. So this should be able to load very fast. It depends on your internet. If this video helps you, please don't forget to give a thumbs up. Also, you can comment and share it. So we're going to close this. Then next step that we need to extract. You see, this is the zip file, so we're going to extract it. Then you click extract. We're going to extract it to click on builds and extract all. Now you can see these are the two files it has extracted. The zip, we don't need it anymore. We're going to just to delete it. Then now we have our WordPress folder. So we're going to rename this folder to the right web name of the website that we need. For example, we need courses. So I'm going to type it as courses. Then I save it. Now we're done with this step. So we're going to another step is create MySQL database. So we're going to WordPress.org again, go to menu and go to hosting. So in this case, we're going to databases. And in case you've installed before, you'll get manage. But in case you don't, you're going to get create new database. So as you can see, I have very many databases already here. But in this case, I want to create a new one for courses. So I'm going to select standard and select and create. So this is going to give a description. This time I need MySQL, and you give it me. I'm calling this courses, and put in the password that you can be able to remember, because we need this at some point. So we're going to save it. Now you can see the website, the database being created. So I'm going to refresh this. Now you see all the details have come in. So let me open a notepad so I take note of this, because I need this, some of this information for the installation of WordPress site. For example, I need a database name. As you can see, the first one on top. So let me copy it. Yeah, then let me first put this to be able to view both sides. Now you can see I also need the database username. So see, I'm copying all this information. You need all what I'm copying. You must also pick it, and if you can remember, there's no problem. But if you don't, make sure you write it somewhere. That is the basic what you can do if you're learning something. So you make sure you get all this information perfectly, and you can see what I'm copying and should be corresponding, so that when you're installing WordPress, you have any challenges. So this step is now done. So let's go to the another step. That's step number four. We're going to connect a domain to the directory where we installed the WordPress. Go to menu and go to domains and SSL. So in this case, we're going to select the domain that we need to connect. For example, I have my main domain, but it's already covered. You can see it's click and builds. But if I open, I have other subdomains here. You can see I have four of them, but all of them are in use, although there is one which is not in use. But for this, if you look at down there, click and builds connected somewhere, it means already sealed. But you can click adjust, you see, adjust destination and be able to connect it. But for this case, let me create a new subdomain, and I'm just going to create and call it courses and save it. So now you see it's been created. Maybe let me just refresh it a little bit. I'm going to click on the domain and SSL again to make sure that it's there. If I click, you see now there are five, and you come here, the courses subdomain is also there. So I'm going to click adjust destination. Then I'm going to connect to WordPress. So here, it's going to be click and builds, but make sure you open inside and click on the name of that subdomain, its courses, then you save it. So you can see it's not showing, but I'm going to refresh it and you'll be able to see that it's connected. It's also, but if you see again, you're going to repeat the process to make sure that it's fully connected. So let me repeat it and until I'm able to see that it's showing. Click on builds and courses. Just this time I'm just going to save it, because you see up it's showing courses. So you see now you can see it's connected. If I click domain and SSL again, and as you can see now here it is click on builds courses. It should be like that before you're able to do it. So let's go to the next step. We're going to install now the WordPress. So I'm going to copy this, Control C and Control V, to paste it on a new tab. And when you open, you see the WordPress installation is ready to go. So make sure what I told you earlier, you copied it. So you see all that is now needed. So you're going to click let's go. And I'm just going to copy everything the other side and paste. But for your case, if in case you didn't save it, just type it directly. Please like this video, it will help the algorithm and move. So let's run, and you see I can leave that. Then see, now this is what you need. You need this now, the information that you need for signing in. So make sure you save it also. The you can see all that, the username, the name of the website, the password. Please save this, just because what this is what you're going to use for signing into your site. So let me save it also on the side to make sure that I don't forget anything. This is a best practice in case you're still not strong or you're using multiple passwords. So it's better you save it somewhere to avoid you forgetting. So let me finish this and click. So you can see I'm saving everything there. So after that, I'm going to put in my email in case I forget the password or anything. So then install WordPress. So you can see success. I've got everything perfectly. The WordPress hasn't been installed. So let me try to log in and see. So you can see that I'm putting the password that I put in at last, not the one for the database. Perfect. Now we have our WordPress fully installed and perfectly running. So let's just do a basic setup. I'm going to remove any plugin that came in with it. I'm also going to settings, general, and try to change a few things here, the description, and make sure here should be as HTTPs. In case it's HTTP, please make sure it's HTTPs. Set up the date and everything the way you want. Put in the logo. I'm also putting my logo around here. So Those are the basic things that you do. In case you just have a specific question about WordPress or about IONOS, please leave it in the comment section, because those are the core things. I know WordPress is not a very hard, it's just a template that you don't need a lot to be maybe mentioned here. But in case you need something specific, please put in the comment section. I'll be able to make a video for you. So for this case, thank you very much for watching. All the best. So you can see this is our website. It's clear and perfect.